foremost, when we get started, we're going to turn to the east. Give all honor and glory and power to
Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushat, Ba'ashem, HaKadosh.
I want to say double honors to our elders, our great apostles, Glenn Millstone, rule well, teach well, being great example to Israel, my dear elect. I want to say peace and blessing to the hope of the elect of Four Corners, pushing the truth and sincerity. I write that great song with the GMS Memphis Camp. We come once again, at it again, through the spirit and power of Yahweh Ba'ashem, the prophesied downfall of Babylon the Great, aka America, man. This great whore, art to be destroyed by thermonuclear missiles, man. And we also come out here to usher in the kingdom of our Lord and Savior, all right, our Redeemer, all right, Yahweh Shah, all right, in the Hebrew, the Lashon Kadosh, the Holy Tongue, all right, he is the deliverer, he is the Savior, man, because Yahweh Shah is the only one able to come back and to deliver us out of this hell, man, and out of the destruction that's coming upon this place, man, all right, and we, today we're going to persecution, because this was going to come upon the prophets, the men of the Lord, man, the true worshipers, man, who worship the Lord in truth and sincerity, man. All right, in faith. All right, persecution gonna come upon us. But guess what? The Lord gonna make a way to escape. All right, so all we gotta do is constantly endure. Like the scripture says, endure hard as a soldier. Endure hard as a soldier, man, of Yahweh Shah. And get what the Lord gonna give us, man. He gonna give us the crown of life, man. He gonna give us that victory, man, which is salvation, man, through him. All right? So we're going to get into it. I hope brothers and sisters be edified while we lay the law down, man. Go ahead, Doc.
So this is Psalms chapter 7, starting at verse 1. Oh Lord, Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah, my power, in thee do I put my trust.
Right, see, in thee will I put my trust. So, hey, when time comes, man, you got to gird your loins up like a man, man. All right, and you got to put all your trust in Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah. All right? You probably ain't gonna be able to have a phone that you can call a brother and ask some questions. All right, so what? Your faith and your trust got relied on who? Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah. All right, this is King David right here, man. All right, a man after the Most High heart, man. And look how humble he is and requiring of the Lord to what? Help him out. The Lord to have mercy on him. The Lord can find an escape route for him. All right, because why? His enemy, all right, is seeking to kill him, man. Here, bro.
This is Psalms chapter 7 and 1. Oh Lord, my power, in thee do I put my trust.
Yeah.
Save me from all them that persecute me.
See, save me. All right, you want the Lord to deliver you, man. All right, for all the persecutions, man. Remember, this devil's gonna come down, have a great wrath, man. All right, you're gonna have your own kin, looking at you strange, man. All right, want your head off your shoulders, man. All for the word of Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah. So you want that spirit, all right, to, hey, Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah, you know, deliver me, protect me, hide me. All right, cover me. Go ahead, bro.
It reads, I put my trust, it said, Salaki, I'm reading from the top. This is Psalm 7 and 1. Oh Lord, my power, in thee do I put my trust. Save me from all them that persecute me,
right,
and deliver me.
Right, and matter of fact, somebody gets Proverbs 30 and 5 real quick. Hold it right quick, y'all. So it said, put my trust in the Lord, deliver me, right? This is Proverbs 35.
It's Proverbs 30, verse 5. Every word of the Most High is pure.
Right, every word of the Most High is pure, man. All right, meaning what is no guile, you see? There's no cracks in it. His word is pure, all right? Meaning what, it's gonna stand. It will not turn back to him void, man. Whatever the Lord has spoken, guess what? It's gonna be manifest. Go ahead, Al.
He is a shield unto them that put their trust in him.
You see that? He is a shield. That's a protector. You see that? He is a shield unto them that what put their trust in him. Just like King David was praying. I trust in you, man. So with the trust, guess what? The Lord gonna protect us. That's what? That's called faith, man. And it's impossible to please Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah without what? Without faith. So really, faith is your shield. You gotta believe. You know? Go ahead, Al.
So this is back in Psalms chapter 7 in verse 1. Oh Lord, my power, in thee do I put my trust that persecute me and deliver me. Lest he tear my soul like a lion, rent it in pieces, but there is none to deliver.
Right, because that's the vain imagination. Because they gonna be out to seek the who? Through the prophets. They gonna wanna tear our heads off like lions, man. They gonna wanna put what it say? That's Luke 21. He said how they gonna break us before kings and the rulers.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
This is back in Psalms chapter 7 and verse 2. Lest he tear my soul like a lion,
right,
rented it in pieces, while there is none to deliver. O Lord, my power, if I have done this, if there be any iniquity in my hands, if I have rewarded evil unto him that was at peace with me, yea, I have delivered him that without cause is my enemy.
Right, see, that's a contrite spirit. Go ahead, bro.
Verse 5. Let thee, Salaki, let the enemy persecute my soul and take it.
Right.
Yeah, let him tread down my life on earth.
Right. He's like, if you see any fault in me, then okay, cool. You know what I'm saying? Cause I know I messed up. You know what I'm saying? That's a real man right there. He admit to his fault. Okay, I fucked up. Okay, cool. What's my judgment? You know? But guess what? King David, he had not done no wrong, man. All right? So he like, damn, you have about Shema Shah, find a way for, you know what I'm saying, find me an escape route. I have done no wrong to these people, but what, they seek to kill me. We have not done no wrong to Esau, Edom, man, to these fucking Edomites, man. We do no wrong to 2/3 of our people. Well, they gonna seek to kill us, man. All right? Our own people are gonna try to give us up, man, for food, you know what I'm saying, luxury. And we done no wrong to them, man. Go ahead, Al.
Psalm 75, let the enemy persecute my soul and take it.
Right.
Yeah, let him tread down my life upon the earth,
right,
and lay my honor in the dust. Arise, O Lord, Yahweh Bashimi Hawashah,
right,
in thine anger. Lift up thyself because of the rage of my enemies, and awake for me to the judgment that thou hast commanded.
Right, and what the Lord said, wait upon me. Alright, wait upon me, for I rise up to the prey, man. So you see the spirit that King David had, man, that's the type of spirit that we're gonna have to have. We can't take battles to our own hands, man. We gotta wait on your high by Chanel shot. So what's up with you niggas out here carrying guns at camp, man? What's up with you niggas carrying guns at camp, man, when the Lord is our protector, man? Alright, here is our shield, man. Go ahead, Doc.
Verse 7. So shall the congregation of the people compass thee about for their sakes. Therefore return thou on high.
Right.
The Lord Yahweh Bashimi Hawashah shall judge the people. Judge me, O Lord Yahweh Bashimi Hawashah, according to my righteousness,
yep,
and according to my integrity that is in me.
Right, because in that day, you're going to want the Lord to judge you according to your works. Because it's written, all right, the Lord gonna judge you whether you have done good or whether you have what done evil, man. All right, so King David like, Lord, judge me according to my righteousness, man, and my integrity. Why? Because it's the inner man, all right, that the Most High look at, man, not the outer appearance, but the inner man, man, who you really are, man. Is you sincere or you playing games, man? And we see now that a lot of you niggas, you Israelite camps, man, that have been set up by the government. Hey, y'all not up your high by Shemal shot, man.
Right.
All right? Because if you was of the Lord, then you knew that you know that you won't need no gun. You won't need a staff. You won't need a sword, man. All right? When you come out here and push the word up your high by Shemal shot, you're going to make the enemy come down, man, and persecute the prophet. But guess what? That's how I set up. All right? That's how I set up, man. Go ahead, bro.
Verse 9 in Psalm chapter 7. Oh, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end.
Right, let the wickedness of wicked, let the wicked of wickedness come to an end.
The wickedness. This is Psalm chapter 7, verse 9. Oh, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end.
Right, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end. That's what we wait on. Here is the patience and the faith of the saints, man, to see the downfall of our enemy. Let this shit come to an end, man. All right, because guess what? It's no word on earth, man, is this gonna progress all right, and come out fine. No, man. This place got to be destroyed by thermonuclear missiles. Got to be cleansed, man, through the fire. And guess what? A new heaven and a new earth that dwell in righteousness, man. Because right now, we're in the midst of deceit. We're in the midst of wickedness, man. Go ahead, Al.
Verse 9, oh, let the wickedness of the wicked come to an end,
right,
but establish the just, for the righteous Most High drive the horse of the reins.
Right, exactly. So Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob's the beginning that follows it, man. Because the Lord will set up the righteousness, but it's going to be through who? Yahweh Shah, man. As he come and devour the wicked, all right, and deliver the elect. All right? Go ahead, bro.
Verse 10, my defense is of the Most High.
Y'all good?
You got
video?
Yeah, y'all
good. This is Psalms chapter 7 in verse 10. My defense is the Most High, which saveth the upright in heart.
You see that? My defense. Should go back to that what? That shield, that covering. So the Lord is your shield, man. The Lord is your defense. All right? Go ahead.
And it reads, verse 11, the Most High judgeth the righteous, and the Most High is angry with the wicked every day.
Right, and that's the point. The Most High judges the righteousness, but he what? He angry with the wicked every day. All right, and that's what you see going forth every day you wake up, man. You look on the news, CNN, what you see? What? 13 kids get shot. All right, this man shot his baby mom because of this. You know what I'm saying? Oh, the girl stabbed her husband because of this. All right, that judgment going forth, what? Every day, man. The Most High is angry with the wicked every day. But mainly the wicked is who? The so-called white man, Esau Edom.
Right.
All right? Why? Because he the one that pushed these laws and legislation to go this bill go on like this, man. Look what today is. Who allowed that? All right? The so-called white man. Why? Because the power is in his hands, man. Come here,
Al. Job 9, starting in verse 20 through 22. If I justify myself, my own mouth shall condemn me.
Ooh.
If I say I am perfect, it shall prove me perverse.
Exactly. Because what? No one perfect. Even Yahweh Shah said that. He said, call no man good but who? The Father. All right? And Yahweh Shah was a lamb without blemish. But he said, no one perfect, man. Because he understood what? Reincarnation. All right? Go ahead,
come on. Though I were perfect, yet would I not know my soul. I would despise my life. This is one thing, therefore I said it. He destroyed the perfect and the wicked.
Man, that's the Lord, man.
I got some.
Go ahead.
This is Psalms 3, verse 1. Lord, how have they increased that trouble me? Many are they that rise up against me. Many there be which say of my soul, there is no help for him in the Most High.
Now bring it back.
This is Psalms chapter 3, verse 1. Lord, how are they increased that trouble me?
Right.
Many are they that rise up against me.
Right.
Many there be which say of my soul, there is no help for him in the Most High.
Right. It means it. All right, when he had to make the soldiers see that it was more of them, got it. I know because when you go to that story of Lisa, he had prayed to the angels to let one of his troops see that it was more angels, more of them than it was the enemy. You know, go ahead.
Psalms 3:3, but thou, O Lord, are a shield for me.
Right, here's a shield unto who? Us, man. All right, go ahead.
My glory, the lifter up of my head.
That's right, go ahead.
I cried unto the Lord with my voice, and he heard me out of his holy hill.
Right, meaning what? He prayed. All right, he prayed to Yahweh Shah, man. Go ahead.
And I laid me down and slept, and I awake, for the Lord sustaineth me. I will not be afraid of 10,000s of people that have set themselves against me round about.
Right, so here it is. King David had that type of spirit on him, man. All right, the same type of spirit we're going to have in that day of affliction, man. All right, when the enemy come in like a flood to gather us up, man, whoever it may be. We gonna have this type of spirit on us, man. Go ahead.
Arise, O Lord, save me, O my power.
Right.
For thou hast smitten all my enemies upon the cheekbone. Thou hast broken the teeth of the ungodly. Salvation belongeth unto the Lord. Ooh. Thy blessing is upon thy people.
See, thy blessing is upon thy people. Come on, man. It's cold, man. Yeah. All right, you see what the Lord have done? He said he broken the staff. He broken the teeth. All right? The Lord got it in. That's why he say scribe unto the truth. And what? Scribe to the truth unto death. And what? He going to fight for you, man. The Lord going to make a way.
Hey, if I can add this, that's funny too, that the blessing went to Jacob. He said, let that bless be upon thy people.
Yep.
Thy people is the Israelites, man. No, that's the birthright, the blessing.
That's right.
You got that.
Yeah, that was it on there.
This is Jeremiah chapter 18, starting at verse 20. Shall evil be recompensed for good? For they have digged a pit for my soul.
Right. And hey, what the Lord says, sin is a righteous thing, then what recompense tribulation to those that troubled us, man. All right, so here it is, in the midst of his downfall, guess what? We preparing what? Slavery for him.
Yeah.
All right, in the midst of his downfall, guess what? He gotta go even downer. You know what I'm saying? The Lord gonna take him out of power and put him in slavery.
Rock bottom.
I'm talking about that's the real true definition of rock bottom, man.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
This is Jeremiah chapter 18 and verse 20. Shall evil be recompensed for good? For they have digged a pit for my soul.
Right, and that's what they doing. They digging a pit, man. All right, with the MOTB. All right, they digging a pit, man. With the legislation they passed. All right, with this money system. They digging a pit for people, man. But guess what? Go ahead, I.
Remember that I stood before thee to speak good for them.
All right, and what we doing right now, we speaking good when you have about Shema Shah. So we actually tell the Lord to what? We actually tell the Lord to call back to mind. All right? Hey, remember, Lord, I was out there teaching. I'm prophesying, warning the people. All right? In your name. Go ahead.
Speak good for them and to turn away thy wrath from them.
Right?
Therefore, deliver up their children to the famine and pour out their blood by the force of the sword.
Now, this is the gun that King David put on the people. All right? He said, deliver them to famine. Go ahead.
Deliver them, their children. Chapter 18 and verse 21. Therefore deliver up their children to the famine and pour out their blood by force of the sword, and let their wives be bereaved of their children to be widows, and let their men be put to death, let their young men be slain by the sword in battle.
Yep, that's Jeremiah, man.
Let a cry be heard from their houses when thou shalt bring a troop suddenly upon them.
Right, and it's coming. That troop is coming, man. Remember, he said it's coming from the north. All right, the north country. Go ahead.
For they have digged a pit to take me, and he ensnares for my feet. Yet, Yehovah Shem and Hawashah, thou knowest all their counsels against me.
Right, and the Lord know all the counsels. Why? Because he set it up. That's why I go to my favorite precept in Baruch 4:18. He that brought these plagues upon you shall what? Deliver you from the hands of your enemy. Why? Because he the one set you up in that position. But guess what? All this is for a testimony of Yahweh Shalom Shah, man. All right, because prophecy got to be fulfilled. Go ahead, Al.
It says, yeah, Lord, thou knowest all their counsels against me.
Right.
To slay me.
Right, to what? To kill them, man. You think the Lord don't know? But you got to be put in that situation, man, to fulfill prophecy. Go ahead, Al.
It says, yeah, Lord, thou knowest all their counsels against me to slay me.
Right.
Forgive not their iniquity, neither vote out their sin from thy sight.
Right.
But let them be overthrown before thee.
Right.
Deal thus with them in the time of thine anger.
Exactly. Why? Because that's the spirit that we're going to have on us, man. Because the vengeance, what the Lord say, vengeance is mine. All right? So even though we got the anger, we got to let the Lord handle it, man. So we put curses on their ass, man. Hey, how about Shema Shah Salak my young? You know what I'm saying? Do this to this, do this to this, do this to this, do that to that. You know what I'm saying? Let it be. All right, guess what the Lord gonna do? He gonna prevail, man. He gonna do it. All right, the Lord hear our cry, man. We just gotta hold guard. You know, we gotta hold it down, man. You know, and continue to serve Yahweh by Shema Shai as the persecution approach us, man. You know? Go ahead, I'll back to the song.
Okay, come. So back in Psalms. This is back in Psalms chapter 7, starting at verse 11.
Right.
And it says, the Most High judges the righteous, and the Most High is angry with the wicked every day. If he turn not, he will wet his sword. He have bent his bow and made it ready.
Right.
He have also prepared for him the instrument of death.
Right, he prepared for him the instrument of death. And what is the instrument of death? The thermonuclear missile. All right, along with the chariots, man, that's the instrument of death, man. Go ahead.
And it says, he have also prepared for him the instruments of death.
Right.
He ordered his arrows against the persecutors.
Woo! He aiming his arrow. That's why I said it shall come down upon our doomers and the people of his curse. All right, go ahead.
Arrows against the persecutors. Verse 14. Behold, he travailed with iniquity, and he conceived mischief and brought forth
falsehood.
This is Psalm 7 and 14. Behold, he travels with iniquity.
He what?
He travels with iniquity.
He traveled with iniquity, man. So everywhere this devil go, guess what he doing? All right? He placing wickedness upon all the countries. Look at it. Look at every country around the world, man. They all got in bed with this whore, man. Everywhere he traveling, that's where he take, man. What I say, death following him. You see, death following this devil everywhere he go. Because the true sin is what? Transgressed against the what? The law, statutes, commandments. And this devil is known by, man. Now go ahead.
Psalm 7 and 14. Behold, he traveling with iniquity and have conceived mischief and brought forth falsehood.
Yeah, he brought forth falsehood, man. Christianity. All right? Buddha. All right? Muslim. You know, Egyptology. All that's falsehood, man. Go ahead.
He made a pit and digged it, and it's fallen into the ditch which he made.
Exactly, man. The ultimate, they're going to be World War III, man. All right? Because when he tried to implement the MOTB, the Lord going to slap the shit out of him, man. All right, and he gonna have to lay in that bed that he made, man. You know, because ultimately he think that through World War he gonna prevail and he gonna come out and make America great. But no, man, the Lord finna set up Yahweh Shema Shah, man, the one that's profitable to rule, man. That's what's gonna happen. Go ahead, Al.
Verse 16. His mischief shall return upon his own head.
Right, his mischief shall return upon his own head, man. Go ahead.
And his his mischief shall return upon his own head, and his violent dealing shall come down upon his own path.
That's right.
I will praise the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah, according to his righteousness.
Right, and we're going to praise Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah for bringing the judgment upon this devil, man. All right, as it needs to be so. That's why I say, what that is, Psalm 91 and 8. Grab that real quick, Psalm 91 and 8. The reward of the wicked.
This is Psalms chapter 91, verse 8. Only with thy eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked.
That's right. See, only with thy eyes, it's going to be like, call on y'all by Shema Shai, man. Especially when he delivers. Lord, we'll be a part of this offering, looking down to see a glass. All right, mingle with fire, man. A bug of Babylon the Great. He's going to praise y'all by Shema Shai, man. Right? Why? Because he has not much God in us, man. I even fought with you, man.
Thank you.
execute the poor.
Right. Wicked in his pride, man. Don't persecute the poor. Game, you know what I'm saying? Good football game. That's what they doing behind closed doors, man. figured out a way to trap your ass even more.
Yeah, like these school shootings happening, or shoe mass shooting happening. They passing legislation, you know?
They practice it because it is in the power of their head.
The earth was given into the hands of the wicked. All right? But guess what? The Lord is going to stop that. Like the scripture said, let the wickedness of the wicked be cut out. And guess what? The Lord going to cut them off, man. Go ahead, Doc.
This Psalms 10 and 4. The wicked through the pride of his countenance.
Look, the wicked through the pride of his countenance, man. Because he walk around here and really bad ass, man. Why? Because the Most High ain't execute judgment upon him, man. So it's in his heart to continue to what? To do wickedness. Go ahead, Doc.
The wicked through his pride of his countenance will not seek after the Most High. The Most High is not all in all his thoughts.
Woo, and the Most High is not in his thoughts. Come on, man. Think about it, the Bible. You know what I'm saying? It's not in the fucking Edomite's hearts, man. Because if it was, then he wouldn't allow certain things to happen. He wouldn't allow certain laws to be passed. If the Lord was in his what? In his mind, man. But guess what? He transgressed about one. You know? This devil transgressed. All right? Come on, man. It's not in this devil, man. Go ahead, Al.
This Psalm 10 and 5. His ways are always grievous, thy judgments are far above out of his sight.
That's why I say,
It's Hebrews 12, verse 16. Go ahead. Least there be any fornicator.
Yeah, that's it, yeah. Least there be any fornicator, right?
Or profane person as Esau,
right?
Who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright.
Right, outside the temple, he sold his birthright.
For ye know how that afterward, when he would have inherited the blessing,
right?
He was rejected. For he found no place of repentance, though he sought it carefully with tears.
Man, now read that again, Karai.
This Psalms 10 and 5, his ways are always grievous.
His ways are always grievous, right? Go ahead.
Thy judgments are far above out of his sight.
See? Go ahead.
As for all his enemies, he puffeth at them.
See? And all his enemies, he puffeth at them. Remember, America was their great country with the great army, Marines, you know what I'm saying? The Navy. You know? Yeah, America was deep on the block. But now you got Russia, which is Craig.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But guess what? He's gonna knock his ass off his block. You know?
Hey, if I may add, because I had looked up how long the dollar has been falling. I was saying for the last past 20 years, I was like, oh man, it's cold.
It's pretty biting. So what the add up with?
Come on,
the add up what? 1969, 1970. See, the add up. You know, man, when that happened, what? The spirit entered to the earth through our business. You see that? And also, there could be a prophecy. I would not be moved. Like, that's a proud motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? So guess what? Esau is a proud being. You can't call him a human being, because human means color. So he is a proud being, man. Go ahead, Doc.
And his mouth is full of cursing.
And his mouth is what?
full of cursing.
Ooh. Full of blasphemy. Yeah,
blasphemy, everything. Look what he trying to do, man. All right, he trying to put an implant microchip in a bin. Yeah. Come on, man, you can't tell me that's not that, man. Come on, bro. Go ahead, I.
His mouth is full of cursing, deceit, fraud, under his tongue, mischief, and vanity.
That's Esau to the T, man. All right? That's the serpent. All right? That's that dragon. All right? That's what we're talking about. Esau, Edom. That's his characteristic. Because that's all he comes with. All right? But he say, he's speaking sweetly with his lips. But guess what? He imagined how well to throw you in the pit. Because that's all he coming with. It sound good, but guess what? It's not good.
It said he sit up in the lurking places of the villages.
Right, he sit in the lurking places of the village. He always in the motherfucking hood. You know what I'm saying? All this shit that's going on, he lurking on the expressway. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, man, he don't get no breaks. Then you got Jake that overdo the shit. Like, God damn, I'd rather get stopped by anybody than Jake. But that's how they sit up.
It's a dog game, too.
You all right. they fucking the dog. You know how they get down. But he said they sit in the lucky places, all right, because they train. All right? These police are trained on a force, man, to go after the minorities, man, which you Negroes, Latino, Native American, Spanish. They train to, man.
Go ahead, at the secret places, do if he murdered the innocent.
Right, he murdered the innocent, man. Who is the innocent? The Israelites. All right? Go ahead, Al.
His eyes are proudly set against the poor.
His eyes are proudly set against the poor. Everybody say. That's why I say in Micah 1, all right, it's in their heart, it's in the power.
To divide
the people. To divide the people. They can't go to sleep without thinking of a way how to destroy Jake.
Man,
come on, man, you can't tell me that this is not your fucking enemy, man. You can't tell me the so-called white man don't hate you. All right? That he can't even fucking go to sleep without, hey, what you think about taking away their rights of guns? What you think about that?
Yeah, that
sounds good. Of course, I mission, you know, bring back, you know, new world order, so yeah, I think that's right.
What about my own people?
Yeah. He said, fuck, man. If they ain't over this tech bracket,
you know,
fuck them.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? They not on the stopping line. Like, fuck them, man. Go ahead. I'll definitely say again.
This is Proverbs chapter 4, verse 16. For they sleep not, except they have done mischief.
Right.
And their sleep is taken away unless they cause some to fall.
Right. So their sleep is taken away if they what? If they don't cause one to fall. They can't even get no sleep without doing wickedness, man. But guess what? Prophecy had to be fulfilled, so that's the Lord dealing on the left-hand side, man. You know, to bring the kingdom of heaven, man. Go ahead, Al.
This Psalms 9, verse 15 and 16, the heathen are sunk down in the pit that they made.
Ooh, the heathen are sunk down. You see it. You see the curses coming about Jake and Israel to Esau, man.
We see it.
Because now, huh, we say,
so we see it.
We see it. Because when you pull up to a red light, you know, back in the 80s, early 90s, early 2000s, yeah, you're good, Jake. But now when you see, fucking Edomite. And then he called himself a fucking what, a veteran. So he didn't went to the army and served 25 years, 10 years, 8 years. And here it is, he got no help from the government. But he didn't serve his life in the fucking army, man.
Honorably.
But where the honor at? He's a fucking homeless guy, man. And most of them be Edomites. So we seeing the curses, as Deuteronomy 37 say, all these curses come upon our enemy and those that persecuted us, man. And you see that.
Hey, I gotta get a precept.
Go ahead, Al.
Hey, this point in 14, but I'm gonna start at 13. Job 5, verse 13 and 14. He taketh the wise in their own craftiness.
That's the Lord.
And the counsel of the forward is carried headlong.
Man, you know the Lord got Esau in the trick bag. He got it sounding so good to eat. Yeah, we're gonna do it like this. The Lord like, yeah, cause once you do it like that, I'm gonna have to do it like that. You know what I'm saying? It just adding up to the point, boom. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That's how it's gonna happen. So that's why I said the Lord should have him in derision. You know what I'm saying? When we went to that word derision, the Most High got Esau in the trick bag, man. He gonna be a laughing stock. Go ahead, y'all talking about.
It says, verse 14, they meet with darkness in the daytime.
Woo!
And grope in the noonday as in the night.
Yep.
So they got that vampire spirit.
Right.
You know? Hey, I mean, you really look at Esau, even from a physical standpoint, he don't like to be out in the daytime.
Uh-huh.
I mean, just physically, the sun is too overbearing for him, you know? Just from that aspect. Yeah. But then his spirit, he got a spirit of light and he got a spirit of darkness. The righteous have a spirit of light. Esau got that dark ass spirit.
Yeah.
You know?
Most of them are trying to hide their eyes, dark,
yeah.
Their eyes and shit.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, you see all the vampire movies except for Blade and Vampire and Blue
Bro. Yeah, bro.
You know what I'm saying? And shit, in Vampire Brooklyn, shit, Blade was killing. He could walk. He could be out in the day. He was killing the vampires.
Yeah, what's the other?
You know what I'm saying?
Eddie Murphy played in.
Yeah.
Vampire in Brooklyn.
But that's that spirit. And, you know, they go out seeking blood at night.
Uh-huh.
You know, they like to hunt in the dark. You ever watch them shows? Night hunting.
Yeah.
They be Edomites doing that shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's Esau. I got this word grope. I want to get this word grope, man. Let's do what it say. So this is grope in the Blue Letter Bible. Right? It says, H4959, Mashasha, I guess. I don't know. Salaki, if I ain't pronouncing it right. But it says, outline of biblical usage. One, to feel grope, to feel over or through.
Mm. To feel through.
So the daytime represents righteousness. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
In the daytime, he feel through. Like, he don't got no life. When it comes to righteousness, he has no mind towards living righteously, man. You know? But in walking in darkness, like we're saying, Baruch, walk in the light that you may be illuminated. You know, being illuminated makes you feel good. You know what I'm saying? But he's only gonna feel good if he do wickedness. That's it, and that's his illumination. He's enlightened with wickedness. See, he got a dark spirit that he pushes over the earth, and people look at him as if he's the Most High, as if he's a righteous, innocent being.
Yeah.
Now you try to tell Jacob, the so-called white man, the devil, oh no, like Job, which I call the Northern Kingdom Job. Like Job came by the main camp with the apostles last Saturday. But as soon as they said the so-called white man was the devil, oh no.
Yeah.
Like he was being melted or some shit, because you said that to our people.
Hey, Jake,
they
Jake
just melt their spirit.
That happened to me earlier. Jake changed the subject. He said, man, at the gas station, he's like, oh man, I see you got a Bible. I like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? He's like, yo, you go to church? I said, nah, he said, yeah, church is within you. I said, yeah. And we get to talking. We get to talking all day about slavery, but I'm trying to tell them who y'all are. Like, no, this is like according to the Bible, the so-called white man. You know what I'm saying? So if we get on the so-called white man, I try to tell them that he the wicked. I went to Job 9:24. He's like, I gotta go.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I gotta go. You know what I'm saying? I was like, damn, quick. So you get on the bike, man. He gotta go, man.
But Proverbs 28:1 say, the wicked flee, no man pursue.
Yeah.
You know?
Take God about it now.
Because the spirit of the righteous is going to bear witness with the spirit of the righteous, man. Right? You know, and the people that try to justify the wicked, when you tell them who the wicked are, that's what they do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not going to feel no type of way about what this man has done to your people and you. He'll start deflecting. But what about, shit, we killing each other every day.
Right.
But who is the source?
Right. Who's the root problem?
Jake be too caught up in the goddamn straw man shit to get into the main objective.
The root of the problem.
Yeah, the root of the problem.
That's why Apostle Hart had named right Plantation Christianity.
That's right.
All right, because that way of teaching came from what, the plantation.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because this devil have not shown no mercy. But here it is, he want us to show him mercy. Us to show other, you know what I'm saying, people mercy. But here it is, this devil never showed no one mercy. Even to this day.
He used the Bible, the same Bible that we trying to show you,
man,
who you are. He used the Bible to show you who you not, who you ain't. He used the Bible to show you that you was a slave, when it come down to it, when you read in the Bible, he's the slave.
Exactly.
He's the one that was supposed to be serving, right? Jacob and Esau, the elder shall serve the younger, right? But he went out of his way to make a slave Bible to justify you being inferior to him, to put himself as the gods of the earth.
Yeah.
How you the gods of the earth and the sun is doing more damage to you
exactly.
Doing more damage to you than it is helping you. The sun was created by God, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah, that's one.
Why would God make an instrument that destroys itself?
Here it is. Jesus got put on tan lotion and
yeah.
Shit. Yeah. Really? But here it is. He brought the son of God though. Come on, man. That shit don't make no sense, man. But that's Christianity. You know what I'm saying? Now the Lord said he was still worship the true worship. They're going to worship in the in spirit and the truth. They're going to come out here and prophesy, all right, and warn you of the greatest judgment day in truth and sincerity. All right, with the 100% truth, man. That's why I had told the lady. She said, so you a 5%? I said, no, ma'am, this is the 100% truth. You know what I'm saying? It's not sugarcoated, not watered down. This is straight drop, you know? From your high about shit on the top, man. Got it out. You done on that talking about?
That was it. Right.
This is Proverbs 28:10. Whoso causeth the righteous to go astray.
Right. Who do that? Who do that? The accuser of our brethren. Get that out. Read that again, we're gonna get that crease out, brother, man.
This Proverbs 28:10. Whoso causeth the righteous to go astray in an evil way, he shall fall himself into his own pit.
That's why I say the blind lead the blind, both shall what? Fall in the ditch. And that's what's gonna happen to this sucker, man. Alright, that's what's gonna happen to him, man. The Lord gonna bring it upon him, man.
But the upright shall have good things in possession.
Right, the upright, which is who the elect, man. We're going to have good things in possession.
Our team.
All right? But guess what? Those that went to Egypt for help, they're going to be destroyed along with the so-called white man, man. Yeah. Read that again, you got it?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
This Proverbs 28:10. Whoso causeth the righteous to go astray in an evil way.
Right, see, who did that? Who did that right?
Right.
Who did that right? You know what I'm saying? Who did that, man? Who got women want to be men? Who got men want to be women? Who did that right? Is that not an evil way, man? Who caused our people to do that, man? the so-called white man.
Yeah, yep. He signed off on it.
You hear me?
I got to preach something.
He signed off on it.
Oh, yeah. Of course.
Gave Wickedness a whole month to celebrate.
A whole month, bro. This shit ain't going to go on in the kingdom of heaven.
Hell,
a whole month to celebrate. Pride, this shit not going to be allowed, man. You have a shot kingdom, bro. Oh, fuck no. That's how you know this is Babylon. That's why it says, as it should overthrow. Wait, no, back matter, bro. Isaiah 3. But he said he had saved a remnant. Didn't I say that remnant? He was destroyed it, bitch, like Sodom and Gomorrah, man.
Then Salakia, our people so simple. I'm starting to see more people celebrating this shit. I'm looking like, damn, y'all look like y'all straight. Like y'all actual heterosexual people. What the fuck y'all doing? You know what I'm saying? But Jake don't want a reason to celebrate and do the fucking cha-cha slide and shit. Do the goddamn Cupid shuffle and shit. Anything this man deems a holiday, he take his simple ass out here and celebrate.
Hey. That little apostle on Rumble I was saying, man. Like, then I know Jake's getting man. Whatever the fuck our white man say, they good.
Right.
You know, don't give a fuck. Yeah, we celebrate National Boyfriend Day. They National Boyfriend Day, yeah. We bobbing here.
Look at this
here.
Shit. Wish I had spiritual authorization right now.
Man. Go ahead, Al.
This bullshit, man.
This is Revelation chapter 12, verse 10. Right. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now has come salvation and strength. In the kingdom of our power, in the power of Yahweh Shai, for the accuser of our brethren is cast down. The accuser before our power, day and night.
The righteous is more excellent than his neighbor, but the way of the wicked seduces them.
But the way of the wicked seduces them. Matter of fact, right at Jeremiah 9:6. Because what? We're in the midst of what? Deceit. So it seduced certain people, man, but through the Spirit, the Lord, what? He brought us out of darkness. Yep. See, we weren't consumed to Babylon. Right? Because the Lord had what? He had a plan for us, man. But we see 235 people, they engulfed in Babylon.
Hey, the truck say sexy red. Yeah, Esau made red look sexy.
Yeah.
Told you it was white.
Yeah.
Told you.
Right. But red
was
sexy.
Yeah, told you red was sexy.
Yeah, that is light skin.
It's Proverbs 12:26. The righteous is more excellent than his neighbor.
Right, and that's true. See? Go ahead.
But the way of the wicked seduces him.
Right, the way of the wicked seduces him. Because what Jake have, man? Jake have nothing. So when Jake see an opportunity, what, he go for it. That's why niggas sell they soul.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because what? The wicked seduced him. Look what I'll do for you.
A literal contract, dumbass. It's the content that you putting out that's destroying your people. You supposed to be, the scripture say, is it not for you to know judgment? You supposed to be the righteous vessel.
That's right.
That's how you selling your soul, you dumbass, delinquent, fucking base-ass beast, man.
That's what it is, huh?
That's how many people have no understanding, man.
Yep.
But then to go as far as to say if it was possible for them to literally sell, because he don't even understand what selling the soul really is.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's more than just signing some paper. That ain't really, that's the shit they show you on TV. The man with the horns coming. Here, sign right here.
Yeah.
No, man. It's about what's coming out of your mouth, man. It's about what you're using your vessel. The energy for what you using your energy? Are you using your energy for the righteousness of the Most High? Are you using it for the devil?
Hey,
that's selling your soul. When the energy that you bring forth in the earth amplifies a perverseness and wickedness, that's selling your soul to the devil.
Right.
You ain't gotta have a fucking devil. You ain't gotta have a fucking dime to sell your soul to the devil.
Right. Look, get your boy.
Hey, can look Wayne being a prime example. No, to the point, Lil Wayne
like
what the fuck. But the
greatest rapper, what he promote.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He positive
in his
music.
I can't hear you. Most of that shit devilish, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
When
he
was dealing with
Lil
Wayne. You know,
but
that's
what
he
said.
Yeah.
But
he didn't
want to
like it.
No.
First called out
Eric B. and Rakim. Mentioning them because I was listening to their lyrics and I was actually looking at the lyrics.
Yeah.
It wasn't even really no what they call profanity even in the music.
It was a poetry.
You know what I'm saying? And then they was just uplifting each other. They was just uplifting, you know, and they was taking bad times and making the best of them. They was speaking about the bad times they was living. You know what I'm saying? Like, she this whole one right here.
Yeah, this whole one.
No, but she come out first.
You know what I'm saying? Fight the power, do this and do that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But now look what she promoted.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, they do out people
the
like
big ass queen hair.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Hey, Jake had a whole song back in the day rapping about a good soul food plate. Remember that song about macaroni and cheese, cornbread? I can't think of the song, but I mean when I was young, I said, damn, this what y'all rapping about. We used to think, cause even when we was coming up in the 90s, rap was going to get the money, cause they used Tupac and Biggie and Death Row and Bad Boy Records. Like to that was the foundation of the culture of the music that we got today. 3-6 Mafia. Yeah. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying?
It turned into gangster shit, man.
Yeah, gangster.
Y'all remember what was that group name, man?
N.W.A.
Eazy-E. Everyday People.
Yeah, I was into them. Development.
Something.
What is it?
Arrested Development.
Arrested Development. Yeah, I was into Everyday People.
That was jamming. Like, you know what I'm saying? That shit went way away from that.
Yeah.
He said I didn't want to take.
Hey. In that song, Everyday People, he was condemning niggas.
Right.
He said the niggas came up, he called them niggas. He pretty much was saying, people call his people African people being niggas. You know what I'm saying? So they weren't calling each other niggas like that back then. You know what I'm saying? Jake wasn't doing the shit that he's doing now back then. But he been seduced going back to the scripture. You got it, huh? Y'all got it.
This Proverbs, back a little talk about it, Proverbs 28 and 4. They that forsake the law praise the wicked, but such as keep the law contend with them.
Yeah, see, when you keep the laws and you keep the ways of the Most High, you're going to speak out against wickedness. You're not going to sell your soul.
Yeah.
You see?
That's right.
No matter what, you know, your morals going to see, it's certain principles that you gotta live by to really be a man.
Hey.
Like I say, you stand for if you stand for something or you fall for anything. Yeah. But what gives you the ability to stand for something? Your morals, your principles. There's certain things that you just not gonna do no matter what.
Hey, like a nigga saying he'll slap his mama for $1 million.
Yeah.
You got niggas out there that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like
my man on Friday. Put my cold,
come so out good,
Will
make
Smith.
You slap your mama.
Yeah. Will Smith style, man. Your own mama, man. That's just, you know what I'm saying? That's a low type of nigga, man.
You got niggas like Charlamagne, and they'll sit up and have, on the Breakfast Club, they'll sit up and have debates. Would you suck a ride for $1 million?
Man.
Oh no.
You know what I'm saying? And that nigga will tell you, hey, I wouldn't ever let nobody know, but yo, you know. You just let us know, nigga.
Hey, I just wanna make a quick
white
point.
White man
tank. Hey, like another, you right. You said slap your parents for $1 million.
Right.
That's selling out.
Yeah, that's selling out.
And also this is in law. If anybody hit their parents, you should be put to death.
Honor thy mother, thy father.
Well, that's in the law. You should hit your parents, hit your father, hit your mother. You hit her, you slap her for a piece of chicken leg. Yeah. Hey, you gotta be put to death. You don't want to touch your parents, man.
That's right, bro.
Yep. You know?
This Proverbs 28 and 5, evil men understand our judgment, but they that seek the Lord understand all things.
Yeah, Ezekiel 21:15.
Understand not the judgment.
No,
that's
it.
Because Esau eat them. See how it say he's softly kept him with the children? Wait, he was found what? No place of repentance. You don't know the judgment will be high by Shimon. That's why the earth is ran the way it's being ran now. Because he have no judgment or no correction, no righteousness in him, man.
Yep.
Hey, King.
Because you see how Jake act. You see how Jake act now. When Jake is, damn, it slipped my mind.
Go ahead, bro. They come back.
All right, this is Exodus chapter 21 and verse 15. And he that smiteth his father or his mother shall be surely put to death.
Ooh. So the Lord cover all anger, man.
Yeah.
Hence the scriptures, man. Basis instruction before leaving earth. You know? The conclusion of life, keep the commandments and fill you up with some shine.
And you got them Edomites.
You got it.
You go on Moore, watching Moore and J.
Jerry Springer and shit.
Jerry Springer.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he had, but that shit real too though with them Edomites. They kids be beating their mama and their dad ass.
It was some Edomites back in the 90s, man, when I was a kid. I forget their name. It was two twin brothers. They fucking put their parents to death, man.
Damn.
I forget what their name was.
Menendez.
Menendez, that's it. Yep.
Hey,
the Menendez brothers, man.
Aaron Hernandez?
No, Menendez.
They were two brothers.
They flat out. That's how you know Esau don't give a damn about that.
It's their spirit.
It's their spirit, man. Yeah. Esau, hey, you see him, man, little kid pulling away from their mom. Fuck you, mom.
Because these Edomites.
Pull away from their mom and stuff.
These Edomites don't have no morals.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? They don't have principles, man.
Yep.
You know, these motherfuckers emotional, just like women, man.
Yeah.
They work off emotion.
But the righteous man. They got standards.
Yep.
You know, they live by, you know what I'm saying, statutes and, you know what I'm saying, judgment.
Yeah, because this is our wisdom in the sight of the Lord, keeping the laws just commandments.
That's right.
So the Lord gave our laws how we supposed to conduct ourselves. Obey your parents. You, what is that? Disobedient child live half a day. So if anybody, you know, hit their parents, touch their father, touch their mother, want to hit her, kick her, however it may be, you should shall be put to death according to the law. But everything backwards on this society.
That's right,
bro. Look at little kids say, I want to change my plumbing.
Right.
You know, and your parents say, nah, I don't think you should change your sex.
They can go
and
to the
and he decide to hit them.
Yeah.
You know, and that's okay. Esau probably take the kid away from you.
Yeah. Then what they gonna do?
It's backwards in the society, man.
Yeah. Hey, tell one of these young kids out here now that's celebrating this, man. They can't do that.
Oh, yeah,
and they gonna tell the authorities on your ass, man.
Yeah.
You might lose your kid.
Yeah.
You know?
Oh, yeah, because when they go to school and snitch, it's over with.
Yep.
Hey, I've seen that happen.
Yeah, you had Eve walking by here with all her kids celebrating this Pride Festival down here, man.
That's crazy.
You know?
Hold on,
Eve. That's why a lot of Eves, the nigga woman, gonna die in this society,
right,
man.
That's right.
Go ahead, y'all can know.
Hey, this is
going back into. You grab it, but going back and touch yourself, the wicked.
The wicked. Come on.
Go ahead.
Psalms 97 and 10. It says, ye that love the Lord, Yahweh Shem El Shai, hate evil.
Ooh.
Come on, man. He preserveth the souls of his saints. He delivered them out of the hand of the wicked. That's going back to what Taza Mark was just saying, you know. If you love your house by Shema Oshah, you supposed to hate wickedness, man. You supposed to hate evil, man. You know? How are you so-called man of the Lord? All right, but you go with the flow, you know. You cool with what's going on in this society? Hell no, man. You hate this shit, man.
Yeah, that's right.
Cause this place is fucking wicked, man.
Right.
You know, this is another reason, why Babylon gotta go, man. Why it's gonna burn, man. I knew something was up. I didn't know exactly what it was, but I pulled down. You know, I'm coming down here to camp. This a nigga down here with booty shorts on, bro.
Wow.
Jake down here with dresses, and I'm like, man, what the hell? This is
June.
That's the new norm.
It's June.
That's the new norm. That's the spirit of Revelation 11 and 8.
Yeah.
Hey, being manifested right before your eyes.
Come on, man.
That's the norm. Like this, that ain't nothing. Like when you see that now, it shouldn't even be surprising. It should just be vexing.
Yep.
Like your mind should be like, what am I seeing?
Right.
It should be like, God damn, man.
Hey, that's what I'm from.
God damn.
Hey, you're right too, bro, because I tried to get some Nike shorts from a Jake. He's selling them on the low. He told me, he said, hey, you know, them the new kind, now they short.
I'm like, hold up. That's the norm. You can't even go to the point where you go in a store. You can't even really, back in the day, the shorts used to come down past your knees, hit you on the goddamn, hit your ass on the damn shin.
Yeah.
Now them motherfuckers knee high.
Knee high.
Not bad, knee low.
Come on, nut grab.
Hey, from the waist, right, motherfuckers, be right above your knee. That's where they stopping it. And you know what I'm saying? So it's like, and then you will look at Jake. Jake's so fucking confused. He trying to sag them motherfuckers. How you gonna sag booty shorts, nigga? Right. Cause he don't understand what the fuck going on.
It's the
trend. it's the trend. Bro. He said, oh, this is how they wearing them now. But then he trying to sag them. He's sagging them motherfuckers and they still don't come past his knee.
Yeah.
Hey, let's
go outside and not precept. Go read that precept again,
I'm not.
Ain't my precept.
All the designers are Moe's, man.
Yeah, yeah. Man. Hey, then Jake get tatted up. Hey, not only that,
right, bro.
Jake get tattooed to show up, to show off their thighs and shit.
The baby.
You know?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, little baby.
Baby.
Not Kevin
Gates.
I mean,
the baby. He Kevin Gates.
Hey, I
see.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead,
I
don't like that nigga no way, though. Kevin Gates.
Yeah, you already know.
Kevin Gates.
Nah, he missed the eat booty. Hey, nigga, no way.
I seen him last video.
He didn't let you know proudly. But I was gonna say.
Oh, man.
Go ahead, bro.
I'm funny, man.
But yeah, they get them tattoos, you know what I'm saying? They think it's cool and shit, but they really miss it really
bad, though, man.
You know what I'm saying? This shit wicked as hell, man. JC the thighs and shit. Like, this ain't me riding the car. And you behind me, somebody's car. You know what I'm saying? You got
the
little ass shorts on, look like a female, but you a whole motherfucking nigga, man.
You know,
that shit wicked as fuck, bro.
Yeah, Jake going to Walmart buying
the
women booty shorts. Just to work
out Jake
in.
Had it on yesterday, he had them green
tights
on.
Oh, that nigga finished.
My man was cool, bro. That's what I was gonna say. So like, you notice how all the establishments you go to now, all the jobs, they hiring moles.
Yeah,
man. They purposely doing it to push the acceptance of that agenda. You know what I'm saying? Because now, if you speak out against them at work, you out of there. And then they force you to work with them. And if you say, well, you got to come up with a something other than the reason why you really don't want to fucking work with them. Because if the reason you don't want to work with them is because of their sexual preference, that's workplace discrimination. You up out of there.
Yeah.
You up out of there. But you supposed to sacrifice your, but he making you sacrifice your morals. He's like forcing you, like the Lord said he ain't gonna allow this man to do that. This man trying to force you to sell out, to force you to sell your soul. You see what I'm saying? Cause what he gonna do is he gonna threaten your livelihood. Cause this is where I gotta go make my daily bread at. This nigga just come back here on a pink hot booth.
With a pink hill.
Oh, I got a Barbie dog. Got a Barbie dog bike. And
notice he ain't did that nowhere else. That's just this. You know, it's a spirit on him. It's a spirit on these motherfuckers when you talk about righteousness.
Yep.
And when you call out wickedness. He didn't hear what we were saying. But the spirit, man.
And it's Amos 5:15. Hate the evil and love the good and establish judgment in the gate.
That's what we're doing, man. We're establishing judgment in the gate, man. Alright. Hate the evil, man. And what? Love the good.
It may be that the Lord of hosts will be gracious unto the women of Joseph.
Exactly. Why? Because what blood is upon who? I am. So we must come out here and prophesy and warn the people to get the blood off our hands, man. Alright? That's what we're commanded to do, man. That's why we gotta hate the evil. Fucking Christianity talking about God don't hate the sinner, he hate the sin.
Right.
Man, please.
Come on, man.
Please.
Get the fuck out of here.
That sound good. Come on, man. Hey, that's some bullshit. So the sins commit themselves?
Right. So if that's the case.
The sins commit themselves, though.
Hey, watch me look. If that's the case, what we're doing over here in captivity?
Right.
If the Lord hates the sin, not the sinner, Because who transgressed against the law of statutes commandments? Who broke that covenant? We did. Exactly. That's why we in the condition we in now.
Right.
We broke the covenant. So if the Lord hate the sin, why are we doing what we doing now?
It's a precept.
Yes, yeah,
we brought it out.
It's
right.
Yeah,
it's
right.
Why?
Brought
12 and 6.
Uh-huh.
Yep. And get the root 4. Root 4 and 4. Got it.
This Isaiah 1:9, except the Lord of hosts had left unto us a very small remnant.
Right, which is who? The elect. All right, that cluster of grapes, the Lord have kept. All right, they gave Yahweh shot. That's that remnant, man. Those are the 7,000 was a complete number that would not bow down to the image of Baal, man. That's that remnant. Go ahead, Doc.
We should have been at Sodom, and what should have been? Should have been like unto Gomorrah.
Exactly, man. Look at how this place is turning out. This is spiritual what? Sodom and Egypt. So if the Lord have not preserved the remnant, which is the elect, motherfucker, I'm gonna turn out just like Sodom and Gomorrah.
It is.
You know? Go ahead.
Hey, this is this is 2 Peter 2 and verse 2.
Come on, give us something.
Read all the way down to the
night. Get out of bed. Give us something.
I was
hoping to
get seven.
Always. Right.
You're gonna
get mad, man.
Hey. But say Noah, the eighth person, a preacher of righteousness, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly.
Bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly, right? Which there's a record of that. See, there's a record of that for the reason of anybody that's to live in that manner, right? Afterwards, we're gonna taste the same judgment that they tasted back then.
That's right.
It's gonna eat of that same judgment, man. You got something?
I think I
go ahead. This is Revelation 20:14. And death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death.
Right, the second death is what's coming, right? The new flood is going to be fire and brimstone.
Right.
All right? That destruction that he's reading about in 2 Peter, the second chapter, was flood by a water. Okay?
Which is today, they use the same symbol. The Lord
has
promised us that
he
had never flood the earth with water again.
Yeah.
And it was an abomination.
Right, that's why the scripture says in Psalms 50, what has thou done to take my covenant in thy mouth and declare thy statutes, and that thou hatest instructions, right? Because that's dealing with the whole Bible. But the particular covenant that the Lord made with the inhabitants of the earth is where he wasn't going to destroy it by means of water anymore. He wasn't going to destroy it by flooding it with water anymore. He wasn't going to do that again, right? So they took that covenant and made it an abomination. They took the symbol that the Lord stamped their covenant with, which was the rainbow.
Yeah,
and made
another
that,
reason.
And, right. you making mockery of the Most High. And that's why the Lord said when you go into Wisdom of Solomon, the 12th chapter, he said today he's going to give them a judgment worthy of God.
Woo!
Damn.
He said he gonna give them a judgment worthy of God. I think it's William Solomon, the 12th chapter, around the 24th through 26th verse. Ooh. But go ahead, bro.
Hey, this is verse 6, 2 Peter 2 and 6.
I got it too.
It says, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemning them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly.
Hey, prove it.
Get out of here.
Hey, prove it.
Get out of here, fucking dumb.
Prove it.
Here you go.
Prove it.
Here you go. That's it. That's it. Yeah.
How about the white man? That's the white man.
Yeah, prove it.
That's prove it.
You can say, what do you say? Jesus was a white man.
Yeah. Fuck out.
Prove it.
No.
Tell you something about the white man, goddamn. Where you going? Yeah, bring it out, man.
Bring it out.
I'm going to read it. Yeah,
go ahead and finish 2 Peter 2.
I was just going to run it back.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
It says 2 Peter 2 and 6, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemning them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly.
Just an example. The example, man.
Yep.
All right? So, what it say? Everything written in the full town, what? Written by learning. So, you're supposed to know the example of when you do commit Sodom. You know what I'm saying? You commit a vile act. What will happen? All right?
Man,
the Lord gonna destroy you, man.
Go ahead, bro.
Go ahead. Oh, yep, but guess what?
Hey, but that's why we gotta be out here, man. You know what I'm saying? So you can see the abominations in real time.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? You can see what, see, they not gonna walk up in these fucking haunted houses like that.
Yeah.
And them motherfuckers tell you to come as you are.
Right.
You know? Now don't get me wrong. These bitches will go up in there with some thot shit on. But this bitch is walking around in lingerie.
Yeah, nigga.
You know what I'm saying?
Nigga.
That's all America promote is perverseness and fucking freakazoidness. If that's a fucking word.
Well,
how
right
do you fucking freakazoid? You know what I'm saying?
The fucking Greeks, man. Fucking Greeks and the fucking Romans, man. Yeah. Fucking Edomites,
freakazoidness.
You fucking Edomites is a fucking Greeks, man.
Alright?
Hey, fucking Edomites,
and
man.
And it used to be the freaks come out at night.
Oh,
now them motherfuckers out as soon as crack of dawn.
They hybrids.
They
motherfuckers. They come out anytime.
24/7.
They all in. God damn.
But you
guys
ain't know. Hey, it's too much. He saw, man. This fucking wicked ass society, man.
Yeah, this shit on your watch, E. All this madness on your watch, man.
You gotta pay for this, man.
Yep,
you ain't keeping your house.
You gonna pay for this.
Hey, like we did the lesson last night. With great power comes great responsibility.
Yeah. He ain't trustworthy.
Hey, you gotta answer for this shit.
You gotta answer for this. You let somebody stay in your house for the weekend. You come back, man, shit toe up.
You got an answer for this.
I left you in charge, man. This is what I'm in charge. This
when
I come back to, you got it.
It's Isaiah chapter 3, verse 9. Isaiah 3 and 9. The show of their countenance do witness against them, and they declare their sin is Sodom. Man. They hide it not. It say, whoa!
And because when you go back to Sodom and Gomorrah, them people was doing all that shit in the public.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, see, really America didn't become Sodom until what, 2014? When Obama was in the office. Like, it really wasn't stamped Sodom until they legalized the shit. Because now it's, because remember, it was a closet. I always say that, it was a closet.
Yeah.
Then Obama came through, of course, he don't run shit.
Yeah.
But he was a representative, right? But they use him, which makes sense.
Yep.
Makes sense, right?
It makes sense, you know.
Yeah. The spirit don't lie, man. The spirit come back and the say the thing that has been is the thing that shall be, and there's no new thing under the sun.
Yeah.
So that goddamn walking abomination who you niggas praised, he made sodomy, goddamn it, a walk-in closet.
Okay.
Go ahead, Op.
Isaiah 3:9.
Start back from the top of that.
It said, the show of their countenance do witness against them. And they declare they sin in Sodom.
Yeah, and then what you see, they declare, man, they don't want to have no shame.
Yep. Like, fuck it, this is who I am. Okay, accept me, for who I am.
And declare sin in Sodom.
God yep. made me this way.
Right.
Shame. Motherfucker, lie, man. You want to say that? Okay. Okay, but why did he make you that way? I take that. If any of you motherfuckers want to say the Most High made you a homo, okay. But why did he make you that way? So he could destroy your motherfucking ass.
That's right. Romans the first chapter tell us.
Yep. He ain't make you that way. He ain't smiling upon you. He ain't smiling upon you for being that way.
Yeah.
Cause truly the Lord made everybody. Yeah. But he made your ass that way to destroy you.
Well, it's scientifically proven that. Really, you wasn't born that way, man. It's a mental illness.
No. It's a demon. So, when you go into it spiritually, he gave you over to that demon. Right. He authorized that fucking demon, that perverse spirit, to be on you.
Right.
That's what he did. So you can be judged.
That's right. So going back to Isaiah 3:9, the show of their countenance do witness against them.
The
show of their countenance. I'm gonna read this NLT too.
Say witness against them, right?
Right.
The show of their countenance, man. All right, remember, you can't judge the book by its cover, but what you judge by what is action. All right, what they do, how they do it. That's how you judge a person.
Well, in certain, in the balance of it too, you can judge a book by its cover because the scriptures tell you we're not that pertaining to a man. Cause certain laws, even though the whole law is spiritual, but there's a physical dress code.
Right.
There's certain things you ain't supposed to do because the things that you do physically, it comes from a fucking spirit that's in you.
Right.
What make a man want to wear high heels? These bitches don't even like wearing high heels. So what make a grown ass man want to walk down the street with high heels on?
You got a perverse fucking spirit on you, man.
Yep. It said Isaiah 3:9, the show of their countenance do witness against them.
Exactly.
And they declare they sin in Sodom.
Right.
They hide it not.
What today is? Shit, right. They ain't hiding. Shit, today is my day. Shit, get in hell, man. Go ahead, Al.
It said, woe unto their soul.
Right, destruction unto the soul, man. That you gonna burn, man.
It said, for they have rewarded evil unto themselves.
See, they rewarded evil unto themselves, man.
So the NLT said the very look on their faces give them away.
Yeah, the very look on their faces. That's why you see them come by and ducking the camera and shit.
Stop looking at it. Got the ugly face.
And you see their ass looking from before they even get, they be way down the block. If you know, paying attention, they be way down the block like. Head going one way, they face be one way, they feet be going the other.
Yeah, they
walk on this side. They don't try to walk the street. That
Mo walk across the street. Yeah, right. That one come on this side, cause they no judgment on this side.
He got the see-through shoulder on, the nipple pills and out. Hey, he walk across this street.
Yeah, right, cause we gonna lay the law down over here.
It say they display they sin like the people of Sodom, yep. And don't even try to hide it.
Man.
They are doomed.
Hey, what's that?
They are what?
Doomed.
Hey, they are doomed.
They are
doomed. They are doomed. I mean, they have no cloak for their sins now.
You're doomed going back to the law. So you can be judged by the law now, man.
That's right.
It said they are doomed. They have brought destruction upon themselves.
They have brought destruction upon themselves. Why? Yeah. Because they being what? They are transgressing against the laws that just commanded of Yahweh by Shemar.
What? I'm going to jump to 11. It said, woe unto the wicked, it should be in with him.
So, destruction unto the wicked, because what is going to be dealt with you? Mean what? You won't have no fucking, no breathing room, so to speak, man.
It say, for the reward of his hands should be given him, but in the NLT of 11, but the wicked are doomed. But they would get exactly what they deserve.
They gonna get exactly what they deserve. What they gonna get? Thermonuclear missiles.
Hey, we go right back to that Wisdom Solomon.
He finna bring it out.
Mark quote, man.
If I can say this, because when you deal with the wicked don't have no shame. Huh? They proud about their wickedness.
No shame in the game.
See, a righteous man, it's not that he don't commit sin. It's the spirit that he had when he commits sin.
Yeah.
And the scriptures tell you that the contrite heart. The scriptures tell you that our righteousness is as filthy rags.
Right.
So you would get niggas that don't understand judgment, say who they think they guys are. You better than, you think you better than him? Cause look, motherfucker, the wickedness that we do, we repent for it. We hate our damn self. We don't love our own lives. When I say we hate ourselves, we hate these fucking bodies that we in that's subject to the sin. That's subject to this whole vibration of this place, man. Right. The shit that you have to endure in these bodies, when you really are the Holy Spirit, you hate that shit,
man. Right, bro?
But you niggas walk around in that wickedness, like wearing it like Superman on your chest and shit.
Proud.
Like the S Superman got on his chest, these motherfuckers got the S on their chest for sin. They wear the S on their chest like sin.
Yeah. Hey, okay, that's how Jake pull up.
I come to
fuck me to it.
Like, damn, Jake. Bring that out, Karan.
This Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 12, verse 23. Wherefore, whereas men have lived dissolutely.
Men have lived dissolutely, right? Look that word up. Go ahead. Look up dissolutely. D-I-S-S-O-L-U-T-E-L-Y. Go ahead.
And unrighteously, thou hast tormented them with their own abomination.
Woo. Read it again.
This Wisdom of Solomon, 12 and 23. Wherefore, whereas men have lived dissolutely and unrighteously,
that has tormented them with their own abomination. For thou hast tormented them with their own abominations, man. And be honest with you, that's torment. Because especially for our people, right? For our people, when they do the wickedness that they do, deep down they thoughts, they know they fucked up. They know they fucked up. They have to get up in the mirror every day and look at their abominable ass. Like, damn, I'm like, well, shit, man, I'm me. They swallowing that shit. You know what I'm saying? They know that shit ain't right.
Yep.
They getting up every day swat, that's pride.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Esau gave them the ability to the script to do that.
And just type in stoning. You know what I'm saying? You see a motherfucker get stoned, bro, to death, bro. That stopped a lot of shit. And that was done in public.
That's public.
That was done in public.
In front of the whole congregation.
That's right. It's a reason why those things was done in public.
Example.
To bring prayer upon what? The next one. Thinking about doing the shit.
But it worked.
It worked. I say this. It worked. It worked the same way on the left-hand side.
Yeah.
You see all this wickedness being done openly. Now that thought seduces you. You see, man in high school, man. Yeah. She look like a nigga now. Ew! I used to wanna hit that.
Yeah. Yep.
That's it.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly right.
Yep. You like, man, I know, man, she used to be so quiet and smart.
Yeah.
Look at her now.
Look at her.
What the fuck is this?
Go ahead.
This is a quick one. Deuteronomy 21:21, and all the men of the city should stone him with stones.
Yeah.
That he die, I start 20. No,
you got that word.
Deuteronomy 21:20. And they should say unto the elders of his city, this our son, this our son is stubborn and rebellious. He will not obey our voice. He is a glutton and a drunkard. And all the men of his city should stone him with stones, that he die, so should they put away. So should they put away evil, put evil away from among you.
And you know what would happen? So if somebody was doing this secretly and it hadn't came, they stopped that shit. if they was thinking about going that way, they would stop that shit. You know? So that was actually like bringing forth judgment openly actually would save people from getting stoned they damn self. You see? So that's why we gotta read it. Because it's people that's like on borderline, like, man, I don't know what I like. Like little kids. I'm talking about it's little kids, man.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, man.
Yeah. Elementary
high school. What the fuck a little boy need a tampon in the restroom?
Yeah, shit, bro. Yeah, they gonna start putting tampons in the boys' restroom.
Hey, this society gotta go. Because it's a that should not suffer sin upon that neighbor, uh-huh. man. So us rebuking them. Doing that's true love.
That's right. Hey, on that show, what's that show? Bel-Air. The new show. Ashley on there, she both ways.
Yeah.
She ain't, that's what she's talking about. She ain't sure, but she thinks she like girls. You know what I'm saying? And they teaching these kids at a young age to be open-minded about their sexuality.
Come on, man.
Where
the Lord said
multiply.
Yep. Man should not lay with man.
They done went even one step further with that. Now men can have, they're making it where men can get pregnant.
Artificial
wounds, man. Yeah. If this ain't the devil, I can say, where and who is it?
If you put these people on the island somewhere, man, eventually, man, that island gonna be extinct.
They're gonna be extinct. Yeah, let's take all you motherfuckers and put you on your own private island and see how long you live.
Hey, I'm gonna finish it. It says, so should they put evil away from among you. And all Israel shall heal and fear.
And you know what'll happen? You know what'll happen? They ask to get right. Because all the women that's supposed to be liking women and all the men that's supposed to be liking men, they'll stop that shit. Somebody gonna get in order. Because you know what somebody gotta be different. Then they gonna start killing each other. Oh man, you breaking the code. We don't do that around here. This is an island for what we do. You gotta go back over there with the straight folks. There'll be a war. There's gonna be a war.
Hey man,
but we gotta get the fuck up out of here, man.
Right.
Well, I say we had no continuous city, but we won.
Hey, as soon as you hear what money it is, you be like, because you already know your spirit gonna be riled up when you come out and you're out like, man, I know I'm finna cut somebody out today. I know I'm finna use some expletives today. You know?
Yeah.
Because that's the spirit of the Most High that's manifested through us. He's angry about this, man.
Don't we start our song? He's angry with the wicked of the nation.
Let him go back to Wisdom Psalm 12 chapter. You got it, bro. I want to get that word dissoluted to you. You got it. Dissoluted.
This is Wisdom of Solomon 12 and 23. Wherefore, whereas men have lived dissolutely and unrighteously, thou hast tormented them with their own abominations. For they went astray very far in the ways of error, and held them for gods, which even among the beasts of their enemies were despised, being deceived as children of no understanding. Therefore unto them as the children without the use of reason, thou didst send a judgment to mock them. But they that would not be reformed by that correction wherein he delayed.
No, dallied.
Dallied.
When you go into that word dally, it pretty much means, it's gonna say a few things, it's gonna say toy, or it really means he was slack with judgment. Like he didn't, because the Lord not bringing judgment expediently, that's what it's talking about. He dallied with them. You know, like he got us out here giving them the judgment, so they think it's a game. Because he not destroying them right now, at this moment. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead, bro. Get that word dissolute.
And dally with them shall feel a judgment worthy of God.
Say, hey, they gonna feel a judgment worthy of the Most High. You gonna feel a judgment worthy of a God. Because, hey, does it not say in the law, ye are gods?
Yeah.
See, the whole entire nation of Israel is supposed to be on a God-like level in the earth. The whole entire nation. So the judgment that he gonna bring on you for forsaking his law, statutes, and commandments is a judgment worthy of God.
Woo! Makes
sense. Man.
You gonna be a, what's it, act of God?
Right.
Yeah.
Hey, that's why I say who can turn around, who can turn away the Most High wrath? No one. So you gonna ask to get the wrath of who? The Most High, man. Because the Spirit is what's gonna be upon us, man.
That's Cain.
Hey, did not Yahweh shot? Did not Yahweh shot drink of that cup of that judgment, man? You think he gonna spare you niggas?
Right,
he
right,
had
right.
The whole cup of it. And what Yahweh shot had to go through. So you gotta understand the type of pain and the type of punishment he allowed Yahweh shot to go through. He gonna give Yahweh shot a power to dish it back out 10 times.
Hey, matter of fact. Ezekiel 25:14.
Get that word dissolutely, man.
Hey, that's a put.
Just hearing
that
put fear in me,
man.
You don't want that.
You don't want that,
man.
You don't want that.
Go ahead.
Nah.
Dissolute.
You want some of this too,
old
man?
No. This dissolute in the etymology, late 14th century, loose. Negligent, morally, or religious Latin.
Damn.
From the Latin, dissolutus, loose, disconnected, careless.
Careless, loose, disconnected, careless, man. You know, you live disconnected from the power of the Most High, which his word is his glory, man. His judgment is his glory. He's supposed to be, and say, is it not for you to know judgment? You're supposed to be in tune with the judgment of the Most High. Now you get this word dissolute in the Merriam-Webster dictionary. It says lacking restraint, especially marked by indulgence in things such as drink or promiscuous sex. Degrading aspects, hold on, bro. It run deep too. It run deep. The dissolute and degrading aspects of human nature. Moral depravity or corruption.
Damn.
Wickedness. Come on, man. And that's what he don't consider that he got an answer to someone for the way that he conduct himself, for the way that he lived his life. You know? Because the Most High not bringing forth that judgment. A full throttle, man. You know? But the time gonna come, and it's now really. The time gonna come when the Lord gonna turn up the judgment, man.
Yeah.
Hey, and you think about all these diseases and shit that's floating around, man.
You just read my mind. I wouldn't be surprised if something did happen where some diseases or something come out, like what I said, monkeypox. Something like that, man. Oh. We see a whole bunch of moles just dropping.
They said the WHO, the monkey pox, the WHO said the more vulnerable to the monkey pox is the moles, the one to live that.
Come on, man. That makes sense. That makes sense, shit.
It makes sense.
You know?
Right.
Going in the exit.
You
know, going in the X's and
big
shit.
Big ass sign, wrong way.
Man, come on, man.
Wrong hole, fool.
Yeah. Man, then you got certain cats promoting and shit.
Come on, man.
It's okay.
Talking about it's okay. Damn,
not
man.
Like that's some motherfucking pound on me.
Man, bring it out, man.
Oh, boy. Man.
This is Romans chapter 1, verse 26. For this, because of the Most High gave them up into a vile infection.
Hey, start at 25.
I get about to kick you. This is Romans chapter 1, verse 25. Who changes the truth of the Most High into a lie?
Who changed the truth of the Most High into a lie?
Esau.
Come on, man.
If not, who is it?
Right, if not, who is it? Go ahead. Who did it?
And worship and serve the creature more than the creator.
And worship and serve the creature more than the creator.
Man, this different verse here, right?
Come on, man.
He trying to walk on here. Yeah, man.
Getting his calves ready, man.
And that's what you see, man. These people, they narcissistic. They love themselves, all right? They love anything that make them feel good. It don't matter. Come on, get this, man. Come on, man. You know what I'm saying? Is it not for you to know, not, don't judge, let's say, Job 32:8, great men are not always wise. You see what I'm saying? That's somebody's grandmother, man. Maybe great-grandmother, man. Come on, man. Go ahead, man.
Go ahead.
She all right? It's her world. You better listen to her.
You are not wrong.
Psych. He fell for it. Go ahead.
Who blessed him?
That was just proud of her, though.
Yeah.
We just read
about it. The look on her face. He was trying to tell her, hey, come this way. She
said, in her mind, fuck these niggas, man.
She just threw the middle finger up, bro.
She in the right spirit.
She high.
That's
high.
A good Edomite, right?
Yeah, she in the right spirit. That's what I say. She gushed this whole world. Go ahead. Yeah. You better listen to her.
Bitch gonna crush.
Right.
Go ahead.
For this, the Most High gave them up into a vile infection. For even their woman did change their natural use. Until which is against nature.
Ooh. Right. That was somewhat of an example.
Esau got bulls out on his chest.
Hey, that was somewhat of an example because the man is supposed to lead the woman. You know? Yeah. And the woman was put here what? For childbearing.
Right.
But a woman that bears the child, the seed of a man, she's supposed to be humble. Right? Bitch, you gotta squat when you piss. There's a reason for that. It's a reason why a man stand when cause he above you. Everything about the nature of a man points to the man being over a woman. Right? But woman wanna wear the pants and swing the rod. She probably got a strap on his name on it at the house, man.
You right, she's in charge. You right.
Come on, man.
Sick ass
Go ahead, bro.
And likewise, also the men's, leaving their natural use of the woman, burn in their lust one towards another. Men's with men's, working that which is unseemly.
Look up that word unseemly. Look up that word unseemly. Working that which is unseemly. Give me it in the Merriam-Webster dictionary. Unseemly. Working that which is unseemly.
There's a reason why you got a positive and a negative. You got a
kid, you got a
niche.
Try to get some charge with two plugs and no sock.
Yeah.
How the hell you gonna get some charge with that?
They got male and female parts.
Come on, man.
Two locks.
Yeah.
The hell? This don't make sense.
Who got the word? You got it. You got it all right now.
Go ahead in the Greek.
You can get it in the Greek too. Go ahead. Get it in the Greek first.
Get it in the Greek first?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'll play.
Strong's G808. Aschemasune.
Right. It's an unseemliness, unseemly deed of a woman, gentus.
Of a woman's what?
Genitus.
Come on, man.
Of one's nakedness, shame.
And that's why I said earlier, I brought it up about they got men now with artificial wounds and shit. Now, how the fuck you come up with a way to get a man pregnant, man? You know what I'm saying? You got a man that'll turn into a woman, or a woman that'll turn into a man, but then want to get pregnant. Like a woman that'll turn into a natural woman, a trans. Hey, this shit's so shit fucking confusing. A natural man will transform into a woman and then get with a man and get pregnant. What the fuck? Like, bro, this is the world we living in, man. Come on, man. Babylon. And they coming up with hormone pills and all type of shit to support. See, Esau, you forward in the affliction, man.
That's it.
Like, okay, how can I, like, you trying to legitimize something that's abominable.
Right.
You can't do it. I don't care what you do. Like, if you go look how they make an artificial womb, they take a goddamn fish skin. It's a certain type. They make it out of fucking fish skin. They put radiation to it to make it feel like a... Bro, yes. They take fish skin.
Oh, no.
Make it radio, like microwave and shit. Radioactive, make it...
Damn.
Bro, look this shit up, bro. It's fucking disgusting, bro. And then they freeze that shit. Like, they got that shit on deck.
Yeah, they got it on deck.
They got it on deck, man. And they sew that shit in, like, bro.
They sew it inside the body?
They sew it inside a fucking man, man.
Man, saying ain't so, man.
Come on, man.
Don't tell me that,
man. This beyond sodomy.
Right.
Go ahead, bro. This beyond sodomy.
Man, this. Go ahead.
Did you finish reading it? Go ahead.
This is unseemly in the Merriam-Webster dictionary. Not seemly, such as, not according with established standards of good form or taste.
Not according with established standards of good form or taste, man. That's supposed to be something that's common, like, to know that's not a good thing.
Right.
Like, you look at the animals, you're like,
right. You look at the animals. A dog won't even, he sniffed behind another thing. Oh, shit.
That ain't it. That ain't the one right there.
He might bite, try to bite the
boy. Come on, man.
Get your ass out of here.
But now you look at the animals, they're making the animals more.
The spirit out here got the animals damn near acting like.
Yeah, we just seen a woman, she had the flag on the
dog.
Ain't no telling what they doing to that dog either, man.
Oh. Because really, we supposed to be lords over the beasts, over the animals. So the animals, you know, they can be trained to do whatever.
Right.
Man, I was watching Shooter for the first time last week.
Yeah.
That man dog went in the goddamn refrigerator and got a beer.
Yeah.
He opened the dog opened the refrigerator, got the beer, and brought it to him. I said, damn. I mean, dog, now you can train animals to do some shit. So, if you wanted them to be moles, if you train them enough, they would do, you know what I'm saying? They'll go against nature.
See, that vibration got
that's why I say no, it didn't say that no humans would be saved. It say no flesh would be saved. Not even the animals.
Right. He want everything defiled.
There's more definition?
Not suitable for time or place, inappropriate and unseasonable.
Inappropriate.
In a unseemly manner.
Yep. Go back to the precept.
This is Romans chapter 1, verse 27. And likewise, also the men. Use of the woman running in their lust one towards another, means with men working that which is unseemly, and receiving themselves that recompense of their error which was met.
Hey, yeah, gentlemen. You know, gentlemen. See, words got power, man.
Yep, soft man.
Yeah, words got power, man. You know? Men ain't supposed to be gentle. Men supposed to be rough, man. Men supposed to be rugged. Men supposed to be hard.
Made me think of that song, E singing that song. I need a rough nigga. I need a
yeah. Cause that's the opposite of a woman.
Yeah.
You don't like, man, you don't like, cause you fuck around, I'm gonna tell you something, man. You fuck around and a woman got too much hair on her leg, that shit gonna fuck, man. You need to shave. Like, you gotta shave that shit.
Yep.
Hold on, like, hey, man, you don't want to get back. You're like, hold on, we tell you to shave them motherfuckers. What you doing?
Shit.
But you know what I'm saying? She rub you with them feet and them motherfuckers.
Right.
Yeah, damn, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Soft. Soft needs to feel hard and hard needs to feel soft.
Yeah, right.
That's what the Lord set up.
Opposite of track.
Yeah.
That's right.
But the vibration, though, it's the vibration that Esau pushes out, you know what I'm saying, through his media, you know what I'm saying, that they got the word in their feminized state of mind, man. You know, our women looks out of other women because what they vote on television. You know what I'm saying? See, that's how they see, and then that's how they hear, and then here it is, we're in the midst of deceit anyway. So we live in this freaking-ass society, so it's more good for the flesh to go that way. You know what I'm saying? Then the spirit telling you to what? To fight against you. You know what I'm saying? So that's why it takes the spirit of Yahweh by Shema Shah to reframe you from this society, man. It's not of you, it's gotta be of Yahweh by Shema Shah, man.
Right.
You know? Because if not, you're gonna be engulfed and you're gonna be taken with this place. But if the Lord on your side, you're not gonna be taken with this place, man.
Right.
Remember them.
Uh-oh.
That's it. It came right back. Why do y'all about to take it out? Yeah. Because if not, you're going to be taken. But guess what? The Lord have prayed for us, man. You know what I'm saying? That's why the scripture say the spirit make intercession all right for us, man. Because Yahweh Shah had prayed for the elect, man. He prayed for the men, women, and children, man. All right? To be delivered.
This is Judge 17:9. I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou gavest me. For they are thine, and now mine are thine.
Right, that's the elect, man. All right? The true means, man, is worship and praise how about somebody trying to
trip us. Hey, Spirit, earlier, them niggas that came over on the motorcycles, right? They biker guns called the selected few. You know,
which it was, I was like, because you ain't never seen these, you ain't never. The whole time we been here, ain't no bikers ever parked right here in front of us.
Right.
And the first time some bikers ever parked right here in front of us, the name of their biker crew was called a Selective Few.
Selective Few.
Go ahead, Al.
This is John 17:10, and our mind are thine, and thine are mine. And I am glorified in them.
Right, see, Yahweh Shah is glorified in what you do.
And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world.
Oh, here, talk to you. Look, see, he said, Yahweh Shah said, I'm not more in the world, but these are in the world. He talking about who? Us, man. We in this world, right? Go ahead now.
I have come to thee, Holy Father.
Right, so that's the intercession right there. That's the mediator right there. Yahweh Shah is presented to Yahweh for us. You know what I'm saying? Hey, that's our mediator. You know what I'm saying? So he said, I come to you, Heavenly Father.
Keep through thy own name.
Keep through thy own name. Go ahead.
Those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are.
So that's the spirit making intercession right there. Yeah. All right? That's what kept us being consumed and engulfed in the Babylon. You how about Shema Shah, man? That prayer right there, man. So therefore, when it was time, when the Lord took the powers out of darkness, he went to the light. You know what I'm saying? It was right on time, man. Fall, nigga, fall.
Man, I hope that. Well, I hope that make your horse mad, man. They need to make your horse mad.
Hey y'all, we love y'all.
17:9, I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me. For they are thine, all mine are thine, thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to thee. Holy Father, keep through thy own name those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are.
Exactly. See, we all gonna be on that one accord, man. All right, and what's that one accord? We in that vineyard, what? Looking for that what? That penny, man. Which is what? Salvation. So we all on one accord, man. But guess what? If it weren't for Yahweh Shemashah, we will be consumed to the world. But guess what? The Spirit make intercession.
Yep.
Lord, pray for us, man. Yep. Keep us from out the world, man. Keep us from being engulfed in the world, man. Go ahead, I.
This Romans 8:26. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we shall pray for as we ought.
Right.
But the Spirit itself make intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered.
That's cold, man. The Spirit, man. Y'all was saying, like, Father, you know I'm down there. You know what I'm saying? I know how it is. It's a rough sometimes, you know. The Spirit make intercession, man.
It said, and he that searches the hearts know what is the mind of the Spirit.
Right.
Because he make an intercession for the saints.
Yeah, so we don't gotta put curses on people. You know what I'm saying? Like, you be vexed sometimes. You wanna put a curse. You wanna put a curse on somebody. Like, the Lord already know you vexed. He already know. Like, somebody did something to you.
Uh-huh.
But it might be a family member or somebody close that you know. You're like, man, I want to, but man, I ain't gonna do it. You ain't got to. And you might have some issue in family going on. You know, that you don't want to just tell nobody openly. The Most High, just pray to the Most High about it. He know.
Right.
Verse 27, it says, and he that searches the hearts know what is the mind of the Spirit, because he make intercession for the saints according to the will of the Most High. This is John 7:7. The world cannot hate you, but me it hated, because I testify of it.
Ooh.
That the works thereof are evil.
Hey, the works are evil, man. We testifying.
So we in the same spirit. Yahweh Shai hate this world. That's why he said, love not the world, neither the things that are in this world, man. You know? This whole world is corrupt. We said the whole world lying in wickedness, man. You know? Go ahead,
This Sirach, chapter 15:13.
Woo.
The Lord hateth all abominations.
Right, and yes, the Lord hate all abominations. Thus said the Bible, yeah. The Lord hate and he love. And he hate all abominations.
Hey, and when you go into abominations, abomination means disgusting acts of wickedness.
There you go.
And you gotta realize it's levels to love and hate.
Uh-huh.
It's a certain type of hate you can have for a person where you just might have a strong dislike. I don't really fuck with them like that.
Yeah.
But it's a certain type of hate where you can't stand to look at a motherfucker. Like, get out of my sight. I can't fucking stand to see you.
Yep.
That's the type of hate the Lord got for certain individuals, certain souls. Certain sins have weightier penalties,
weightier
judgments, man.
Right.
You know?
Right.
It's like the Lord said, how you know that, right? The Lord said, whoever come to me and hate not their mother and their father cannot be my disciple, is not worthy of me.
Right.
That's not talking about the level of hate that he got for a mo. Right. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, because that hate going to love less.
Yeah. Right.
When it comes down to Yahweh Shemashah, all right, or the ways of this world, where you going to lean to? You got to lean what? More towards the scriptures, man. All right? We rather serve what? The Most High rather than what? Rather than man. So yeah, we don't listen to our moms and tell us to eat pork or do this and that. Oh no, hell no. But we are what? We gonna give her respect. Like the scripture says, honor thy mother and father. But when it comes down to you, how about Shema Shai? Hell to the motherfucking no. This is what the Lord say, man. This is what's going on.
Yep, that's love less. That don't mean you gonna have no dealings with your parents at all because they don't agree with what you believe.
Right.
But you don't trim your ways for them. You don't go against the Most High.
Yeah, what the Lord said,
yeah, they're like you might have a sister or a relative that's a Most.
Right.
Like, come on down here to the festival with me, bro. Man, hell, I bet you can fuck away from me. Hey, it ain't gonna be just like that, you know? Because the Lord said judgment gonna begin with us. You see? And the most excruciating judgment, Jacob's trouble, the climax of Jacob's trouble is gonna be in America, man. Because they catch a hell all around the earth, like Venezuela, all other parts of the country, all parts of the world, I mean. They don't catch the most hell, and like, ain't gonna be no hell that Jake gonna catch like he gonna catch in the earth.
And I will destroy it from off the face of the earth. Saving that, I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob.
And this is the only dwelling that's gonna be completely removed. In the kingdom, the map will be America's. There will not be America on the map in the kingdom. It's gonna be a straight desert.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, bro.
Said the Lord Yahweh, for lo, I will command, and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations, like a swarm is sifted in a seed.
Right. And the way that the Lord is sifting is through bringing forth justice. Right? So that's how he gathered together his elect. That's what's gonna make Jacob great. Go ahead.
Yet shall not the least grain fall upon the earth.
But everything else gonna fall. The grains are the whole pieces. Right? That word whole, so go with whole. Right? Be complete. Go ahead.
All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword, which say the evil shall not overtake nor forbid them.
Right, all you that's taking the judgment of the Lord smack, like the scripture say, in 2 Peter, the Lord is not smack, the son is promised, that song counts slackness. You know? You think that's counting what we're saying, that some things are not. Hey, we just bug out, we some fools, you know? We gonna see who the fool is in a minute. Cause we know. Jake, you ain't sure what's going on, man. You hoping. You hoping this shit gonna turn around and the America gonna do a 180. Go back the other way. Go ahead, bro. So
being in touch with ease. Give all honor and glory and power to you.
Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Shai, Hashem, Kapadash.
Shalom.
DTA.